Hello, you all know Catherine. We've been making the course together. Today we have a really special guest for you. Alice works for Google and has been working there for
11 plus years.
11 plus years. So we're going to talk about Alice's journey in terms of the first interview, how she solves bugs, and some advice Alice would give herself from way back when she was wanting to learn programming. Mm-hmm. Shall we begin?
So Alice, can you tell us about your role at Google now?
Sure. So right now I'm a TL for a new project. TL is for a tech lead. For a new project on Android. It's in the very early stages, so I can't really talk about exactly what the project is yet. But I can tell you a little bit about what I've been doing the last few years. So
let's start at the very beginning.
Beginning.
You come in and what happens the first few years?
Yes. So the first 6 years at Google, I was in AdWords, AdWords frontend. So AdWords is basically how Google makes money.
Okay.
So when you do a Google search, all those ads that pop up on the right hand side.
Okay.
So I worked on, and AdWords back then, it was like the first group at Google who was doing Java. All the other engineers were, you know, C++ engineers. Yes, so we're like the first Java team. And we set a lot of standards about how Java was gonna, you know, setting the Java coding style, for example, and, you know, what tools to use. So yeah, it was a very fun, I think it was like, back then it was like small, I remember carrying the pager for AdWords, like on weekends, all the engineers take turns carrying the pager. Mm. So if like a server goes down, you have to be prepared to log in, you know, reboot the machine. It was before we had SREs. SREs means site reliability engineers, I believe.
Okay.
So it was like, it was very different.
I had never imagined that when a server goes down, there are literally pagers going off
in
the background, where people are sort of hustling to try and get the machine up again.
Yes, and it could go off like any time of the day, 4 a.m. Mm. So it's kind of like, you know, a doctor being on call.
Mm-hmm. I'd imagine that as thrilling as it was for you to get the job, some parts of the job may be stressful. This idea of this pager is going to go off and interrupt the fun that you were perhaps having. Do you recall any instances where you felt like, this is really stressful and hard work that we are doing?
So I think when I was on Android Gmail, I think that was actually a pretty stressful time, like being TL.
Okay, so we've moved on from AdWords, so you're now doing Gmail, but for Android.
Android, yes.
Okay.
So actually, Catherine and I worked together on
Android.
That's how we met. Yes, we worked on Keep Together. So Android is very different from AdWords.
Mm-hmm.
I think mainly because it's a consumer product.
Mm-hmm.
So there's, you know, it's just a different set of users. This is like, you know, a lot more users. And on Gmail particularly, because it's one of the most used apps on Android, that just the pure number of bugs that we get is just, you know, is insane.
Mm.
Especially like at Google, we have this thing called dog fooding. That means if you're ready, your app is ready to release your new version, then you test it with internally among all the Googlers.
Mm.
So you kind of, you know, dog food your own product, eat your own dog food.
Mm.
And for Gmail, every time we dog food a new version, people will be so passionate and file so many bugs. You know, we move one button from like top right corner to the bottom right corner, and yeah, there'll be like, you know, 20 people complaining about, you know, it changes their workflow, for example. So I think it was very, it was making those decisions was really tough, because it's hard to like find a solution that pleases everyone.
So it may be surprising for some of our students to understand, but this idea of feeling frustrated because a bug has been encountered is not something just the novice programmers are feeling. Even expert programmers like you, Alice, can get bogged down by them.
Mm-hmm.
Do you have a strategy or two you follow when you say come across a bug?
So it depends on the type of bug.
Mm-hmm.
So bugs can be very different. Like, you know, like the most, I guess, important or high priority bugs are like crashes, for example. You know, your app is just not functional.
Okay.
And those are probably ones that will get looked at first. You know,
okay.
They'll flag as P0s or P1s. And also depends on how reproducible it is.
P in that stands for priority.
Priority,
I imagine.
Exactly,
okay.
Yes. So P0, P1, P2.
An engineer who received a bug. Think of a bug, and what would be your strategy to going about fixing something like that?
Bug fixing is one of the most, it's like a very easy way or quick way to, you know, feel like you fix this bug and it's very rewarding because I can mark it as fixed and it's like, you know, I accomplished something. I think usually first step is try to reproduce it. So if it's reproducible, then it's much easier to fix. The hardest bugs are the non-producible ones, something that, you know, on Catherine's Android device you saw, but then on my phone I was never able to reproduce. So that's much harder. So if it's reproducible, then I can easily just look at the logs, ADB logcat on Android devices, and then, you know, see what happened. Like if there's a if it's a crash, then there will be a very obvious stack trace.
So you're like an investigator. You're looking at clues for why this thing might be breaking.
Yes.
Okay.
And Android bug reports are actually notorious for being really cryptic and hard to read.
Really?
Yes.
It's not just us.
Okay. Oh, no. Yes.
I find them to be very verbose and cryptic also.
Yes. Yeah. I think it's, yeah, it's one of the main big challenges, actually. So that's where, like, experience comes in. So if you're an experienced Android programmer, you know exactly which keywords to search for. It's impossible to just read line by line. But I usually just, like, prep for or, you know, search for certain keywords.
I see. And so you're scanning through the entire log and you're looking for keywords that you can Google.
Yes.
Okay. Why are you Googling these things?
I do a search locally.
Okay.
Just like a find. But Google comes in handy because often if there is an error and it's something I'm not familiar with, it could be like Android framework throwing some, you know, illegal state exception or something that I've never seen before. So the first thing I would do is actually Google it.
Okay.
And and usually on, like, let's say Stack Overflow, there's almost always somebody else who has encountered the same.
Used to follow similar processes where they find a bug, they try to identify a keyword that they can search on Google and try and interpret those results and try and fix the bug. Now, what's really satisfying, at least for me as a teacher here to learn, is that the process that we're teaching our students is being followed by an expert 11 years into their program. You mentioned a statement which was really emphatic to me, which is, if I don't know something, and that's really important to understand that even after 11 years of expertise, there are so many things that one might not know.
Yes, it's impossible to know everything. And I realize it's, there's something new to learn every day, actually. And at my job, I feel like I do indeed learn something new every day.